What the hell's going on here?
Hey folks, welcome back to the channel, where I do the kessin so you don't have to. And this one's had a lot of kessin already. It's giving an error code, AE, and beeping when it gets about, I don't know, 3/4 of the way through a cycle. It's got a sensor down underneath that detects that there's water, and that's setting this thing off. It turns out that it was under a year old when the error first happened. Of course, it was over 6 months, so then it goes to factory warranty. So we called LG. The technician from LG first said, well, we have to send you a checklist. You have to go through all of these things, make sure that it was installed properly. If you've ever installed or worked on a dishwasher, you know that only a moderately trained monkey can put one of these things in, especially when it's just a replacement. There's no way it was installed incorrectly. But of course, that's their first hurdle that you have to pass. Once you pass that, then they're like, oh, then you just get a hold of our service department and we'll send out a technician and they'll take a look at it. But if it's, you know, if there's a problem with workmanship or something like that, then you're going to have to pay for the service call. So finally, 6 months of hand washing later, I've been given the green light to pull this thing out. I pulled it out and the first thing we got to do is figure out where this water is coming from. The electrical and the water supply are both pretty short, so I had to disconnect both of those to get it all the way out. Then I flipped it on its back in order to try to diagnose it. I flipped it upside down to try to get the lower pan off. This thing just was not made for doing maintenance on. They get more and more complex and more difficult to service on any appliance anymore. At any rate, the goal here is I need to run this thing so I can see where the leak's coming from. In order to do that, it needs to be in a position where I can see it running. And of course, while it's out here, I don't have enough electrical line or water line in order to run it. So you can see, here's the water line, which needs to come all the way up to the front. And the electric ends right there. So I've got to extend both of those. I'm going to do that and run this. See if we can find the leak while it's running. We'll go back, look at some of the challenges I ran into just getting it out and show you where that sensor is and some of those things. So let's get started. Here's a fun aside, look at that. Tile doesn't even go all the way to the wall. I also love the electric, just run a piece of flex right out through a hole in the drywall. Who needs fixtures? Lazy or cheap? You decide. Now we're gonna hook it up to the dishwasher first, because remember, that's still hot. Good. You can see it's still up warm, but it didn't get me. All right, we get power. All right, to extend this water line, I just went and got another dishwasher line. 4 feet should be more than enough to go the 2 feet that I need, give me enough room that I can move around. And then I got a 3/8 to 3/8 compression connector. Most of this I'm not going to use, but I need this so I can connect this end to the end that comes from the water service. Of course, it's not going to give an error now because I had it on its side and back and it's drained out. So we're going to have to run it probably a couple free cycles so it can collect enough water in there to give the error. Already an error. I.e. input error. Oh, gotta turn on the water. Checking for leaks. And now we wait. So this white thing is the float. There's a little styrofoam float underneath there, but it's the switch that's looking for water. And you can put your finger down in there. There's a little bit of a well. It's dry right now. Looking for any drip, moisture, something. Of course, it's slow enough that it's not going to just jump right out at me, right? Couldn't be that lucky. How do I cancel the cycle? All right, she's full of water. Perfect. Hold this, it cancels. Yeah, there we go. And I assume that means it's emptied itself out. We'll reach in there and see if I feel any water in that well. Completely dry. Damn it. Not yet. I'm wondering if this is it. There. I'm not gonna get a seal, but it's already leaking all over the damn place anyway. Oh, come on. This is such a pain in the ass. I'm not gonna drain. But that'll tell us if it fills up with water. We know that's the problem. Run it through another cycle. Yep, back at the same error. Oh, yeah, we got water all over the floor now. Yeah. I guess full of water. Okay. We know where it's coming from now. There it is. Look at that. That took a lot of work to find.
So I'm fairly certain we'll have to pull it apart, I guess, now just to be absolutely sure. But this F174, let's see if it gives us any more information. God, that's a terrible picture. I was going to order it and then just swap it when it came, but it looks like I've got to pull it out to make sure that that's it. That's where we are. We'll order that up, see if it fits.
All right, here we are a couple of days later. I got this in the mail, and this is the most complex gasket I've ever seen. We got to figure out how to get this in there. Let's get started. Thank you. there she is, removed. And here's why it's leaking. Look at that. It's separated right there. And it's cracked right there. So that's the source of the leak. Now we gotta put it all back in. When I pulled this apart, a piece of waterlogged foam came out at some point. I can't remember exactly when, but you can see there's a piece of, it's just like a low density foam stuck in here, and it's missing over here. So I'm going to see if I can find some weather stripping or something that I can put back into this corner to act as that pad. Not sure what its purpose is, but it was there from the factory, so we're going to try to replace it with something. Turns out that this sponge strip stuff doesn't stick for crap. I've tried several things here off camera, trying to get something that will adhere to it, and then hopefully adhere to the dishwasher. I ended up using this double-sided trim tape. This is typically used in, I don't know, automotive stuff to hold trim onto the outside of a car. So it handles, you know, cold, hot, lots of different applications. So I put a little piece on the back side of this silicone, and then I'm going to put it in here and see if it sticks. Oh yeah, it sticks to that stainless. Yeah, it's not coming off of there. So there's some sort of a pad there now. We're going to continue putting it back together. So now we have this flange here. We need to make sure it's up inside. Yes, it was over the top. You gotta push the rubber part down in. And then seal this down there. Now I should just have to hook it up to power and water, and it should, in theory, work and not leak. Dishwasher repaired and reinstalled. Thanks for watching.